Hi students, back with electrochemistry, episode 8 or class 8, continuing with electrolysis. Now, the most important electrolysis that every one of us has to actually understand is electrolysis of water. As I already told you, water is a weak electrolyte. Since water is a weak electrolyte, to ionize water, it is very, very difficult. To make it as a better electrolyte, a few drops of acid or base is added. So therefore, never when we talk about electrolysis of water, sometimes you may have to take aqueous NaOH or KOH. Frankly speaking, a few drops. The inert electrodes that are generally employed are platinum or graphite. Platinum electrodes being costly, graphite electrodes are preferred. But why did I write star marks to nickel here? Recollecting the first year topics that we studied under the heading hydrogen and its compounds, where we prepared hydrogen by electrolysis. Do you recollect that? Pure hydrogen is obtained at cathode. 99.95% of pure hydrogen is obtained at cathode by the electrolysis of water. Do you recollect? There, a point is mentioned in your NCERT book. What is that? Preferably, you use barium hydroxide using nickel electrodes. That is the only reason why I used that nickel electrodes. Barium hydroxide, nickel electrodes will give pure hydrogen during electrolysis. Coming to the mechanistic approach, generally we don't have much time to talk about the mechanistic approach of electrolysis, but at least in the case of water, I wanted to concentrate by taking little time. I already wrote the equations required so that time will not be wasted for us. What will be the substance undergoing oxidation and what will be the substance, what will be the species undergoing oxidation at anode, what will be the species undergoing reduction at cathode is what we want. As I told you, when I was young, when I was not having so much of knowledge, it doesn't mean that I have a lot of knowledge today, but when not much chemistry is known to me, I used to think that the H plus ion of water undergoes reduction at cathode, OH minus ion of water undergoes oxidation at anode. I used to be under such impression. But as I just got enlightened also by my teachers, water being a very, very, very weak electrolyte does not contain sufficient number of ions. So that is the reason why when I used to write electrolysis of water, H plus undergoes reduction, OH minus undergoes oxidation, I used to write. But today I have changed my approach because the subject is better known to me compared to my younger days, where I wrote water only undergoes oxidation at anode, water undergoes oxidation at anode, water undergoes oxidation at anode, water undergoes reduction at cathode. Simple way, H plus OH minus undergoes oxidation at anode, H plus undergoes reduction at cathode. Simple, correct, perfectionist. Water undergoes oxidation at anode, water undergoes reduction at cathode, no doubt. At anode, what should happen at anode, tell me? Never forget this point always. When I say anode, oxidation. When I say oxidation, loss of electrons. Loss of electrons. When I say reduction, when I say cathode, reduction. Reduction, gain of electrons. This you should know. Every time, don't even have a doubt, what will be the reaction at anode, sir? Oxidation. Even though I am telling that water is the one which will undergo oxidation, for our simplicity's sake, we can say the OH minus ions of the water will actually lose electrons. Therefore, if you see, It may not be a perfect chemistry that I am teaching you, but a simple chemistry to make you understand better. The OH minus ions of water, by losing electrons, will become O2. I can directly tell you to remember the equation, but I am trying to actually make it a little more comfortable. The OH minus ions of water, the OH minus ions of water lose electrons and get converted to O2, H plus will remain as such. Thus, what happens when water undergoes oxidation at anode? O2 gas is liberated at anode. What are the ions so produced? H plus ions with loss of electrons. Now, which part of water has the tendency to gain electrons? H plus. Which part of water? H plus. So, even though I am writing, water undergoes reduction, let us just assume for simplicity's sake, the H plus part of water gains electrons. When it gains electrons, what does it form? H2. So therefore, I wrote H2. Which part of water is actually not participating? OH minus. Remember, I may not be teaching you the things in the perfect manner, but I should say water undergoes oxidation, water undergoes reduction. But for a simplicity's sake, I am telling you OH minus of water undergoes and H plus of ion of water undergoes. I am using the words OH minus undergoes oxidation and H plus undergoes reduction. Now tell me, what is the gas liberated at anode? O2. What is the gas liberated at cathode? H2. Qualitatively, I am telling you, H2 gas at cathode, O2 gas at anode, we got it. Agree? Very good. But I wanted quantitatively. When I balanced this equation in terms of charges, I got 4 moles of electrons. When I balanced this equation in terms of charges, I got 2 moles of electrons. But how can different amount of charge can pass through different electrodes? It should be same. Therefore, I multiplied this equation with 2. So now tell me, how many moles of electrons here? Gained 4. How many moles of electrons that are being lost are lost? 4. So how many faradays of electricity? 4 faradays. Then I wrote directly net equation, 2H2O gives 2H2 plus O2. Sir, how did you get it? Come on here. How many water molecules here? 2. 2 into 2? 4. Total 6 water molecules. I wrote only 2. What happened to the remaining 4? 4H plus 4OH minus. 4H plus 4OH minus. 4H plus 4OH minus form 4 water. 6 waters on the left side, 4 waters on the right side. Total number of water molecules net on the left side will be 2. Give 2H2, 2H2 plus O2. I took a little more time because this is the most important electrolysis that is to be remembered by you. Now tell me, if you see the equation, what is it looking like? Just a decomposition. Yes, don't be under impression that electrolysis means it's a difficult concept. Electrolysis is nothing but a decomposition. Generally, we decompose a substance by using temperature. But here we are decomposing the substance by passing electricity. What happens when water is subjected to thermal decomposition? H2 and O2 are obtained. What happens when water is subjected to electrolytic decomposition? We get H2 and O2. So the same thing I wrote. So this is what is the mechanism, but actually what is the net result that you are getting is hydrogen liberated at cathode, oxygen liberated at anode. Quantitatively tell me, for every 2 moles of water, 36 grams of water, 2 moles of water, 36 grams of water undergoing electrolysis by the passage of 4 faradays of electricity, 4 faradays of electricity, we get 2 moles of hydrogen liberated at cathode, 1 mole of oxygen liberated at anode. At every point of time during electrolysis, we require the knowledge of this particular equations, because there is always a competition. To understand the meaning of competition, I am using a word called discharge potential. Frankly speaking, English is important. Discharge, lose charge. How can a positive ion lose charge, tell me? by gaining electrons, reduction. How can a negative ion lose its charge? By losing electron. Therefore, it is oxidation potential. Therefore, when we go to the next part of our electrochemistry chapter, there we study the same discharge potential under the heading reduction potential and oxidation potential. At this juncture, I am using the word called discharge potential. Please try to remember, if there is more than one ion competing with the other, the ion with lesser discharge potential always is preferentially discharged at that respective electrode. I am repeating once again. Lesser the discharge potential of the ion, greater is its tendency to undergo discharge at a respective electrodes. If there is a competition between more than one ion, the ion with lower discharge potential, is preferentially discharged at that particular electrode. Therefore, how to, sir? I just gave you some beautiful hints. This part I am making it very comfortable by giving you certain hints. Anions like the fluoride ion is the only one, because you remember fluorine is the best oxidizing agent in chemistry. Always F2 is interested to get converted to F minus, difficult for F minus to convert to F2. So fluoride, sulfate, nitrate, carbonate, they have a very lesser tendency to undergo discharge. Their discharge potentials are high. What is the meaning of discharge potentials high? They are not interested to discharge. They are not interested to undergo any chemical change. They cannot discharge. They remain like that only. Chloride and bromide. Chloride, bromide, you can add iodide. Except fluoride, the remaining three halide ions have lesser discharge potential. Where is this problem coming? Tell me. I have a solution of aqueous NaCl. Chloride ion is interested to get discharged. Na plus Cl minus are the only ions, let us say. Sodium ion at cathode, chloride ion at anode. But now I have an aqueous NaCl. Chloride ion is competing with what? Water, or let us say OH minus. Then the question is, who will get discharged? For that particular purpose, this particular discharge potential concept is very much useful when the solution that you are taking is aqueous and the electrodes that you are using are reactive. If it is a fused electrolyte, you need not much worry about this discharge potential. Single type of a cation, single type of an anion. But when you take an aqueous solution, competition comes. In that competition, I just wanted to tell, oxanions and fluoride ion have higher discharge potential compared to OH minus. Chloride, bromide and iodide, halides except fluoride, have lower discharge potential compared to water. Agree? Cations means, what is the meaning of it? If there is a competition between sulfate ion and water or OH minus ion, it is OH minus ion or water which will undergo oxidation preferentially. If there is a competition between chloride ion and OH minus ion to be oxidized, it is chloride ion which has a greater tendency to undergo oxidation. Lesser the discharge potential, better it is. Ion with lower discharge potential preferentially gets discharged at respective electrodes. Cations. All cations, let us say aqueous NaCl once again. Na plus is competing with what? Water or H plus ion. H plus ion or water has a greater tendency to undergo reduction as compared to Na plus. Meaning what? Discharge potential of H plus ion, is much lesser than discharge potential of Na plus. That is the reason why if there is Na plus and H plus ions, which gets preferentially discharged at cathode? H plus ion. All cations in chemistry have higher discharge potentials compared to H plus ion. Exceptions are four. I request you only one thing. When you have cupric ion, silver ion, auric ion, mercuric ion, cupric ion, silver ion, auric ion, mercuric ion, then only you should be always be careful. These are the only four ions. I can take platinum and palladium, but mostly they are used as electrodes. Therefore, I am telling these four ions. These four ions, when they compete with H plus, they are the winners. Winners, I mean to say what? H plus want to discharge. These four ions want to discharge. These four have a greater tendency to undergo reduction at cathode compared to H plus. Other than these four, any cation that you come across, always it is H plus which has a greater tendency to undergo discharge. So let us say, for our simplicity sake, aqueous solutions are being taken. OH first, OH minus competition. OH minus is always discharged at anode when you have fluoride, sulfate, carbonate, nitrate. But when this aqueous solution you take contains a chloride ion or a bromide ion or a iodide ion, it is chloride, bromide and iodide, but not OH minus ion. So OH minus better than oxan ions, but OH minus is being defeated by chloride, bromide and iodide. So now tell me, OH minus sulfate ion, who will get discharged? OH minus. OH minus and fluoride ion, OH minus. OH minus and chloride ion, chloride ion. H plus. H plus is always the winner in most cases. Only four cations, remember four cations. What are they? Cupric ion, silver ion, auric ion, mercuric ion are the only four which may defeat H plus, which have a lower discharge potential. Now tell me, H plus is competing with Na plus, which will get discharged? H plus. H plus. H plus is competing with Mg plus 2. Who will be the winner? H plus gets discharged. H plus is competing with Zn plus 2, which will be getting discharged? H plus. When I say H plus, you can think of water. When I say OH minus, also you can take it as water. But at cathode, reduction. At anode, oxidation. All of you. But cupric, but be careful. Remember these four, please. These four are very important to be remembered. When there is a competition between H plus and these are the ions which get discharged. Is that okay for you? Is that okay for you? Because to do any of the things, any of the electrolysis in a better way, I require you to have this. I am keeping it like this only for some time. Let us take aqueous NaCl electrolysis. What is aqueous NaCl also called? Brine solution. Aqueous NaCl is called brine solution. Using which electrodes? Platinum or inert electrodes. Remember now onwards, maybe I may actually may not have time to write every time. If I don't mention anything, always consider that I am talking about inert electrodes. If it is a reactive electrode, especially I'll mention they are reactive electrodes. Do you remember reactive electrodes? Do you remember copper sulfate in which copper electrodes are there? But here we are using aqueous NaCl using inert electrodes. What are the possible chances? NaCl will give Na plus and Cl minus. Next time, next example onwards, I make the things much more, I can say, easier, comfortable, and I will give you a technique also. But let me first tell you in a detailed manner. And then, so what are the ions? Na plus and Cl minus. What is the solution? Aqueous solution. Now Na plus has to complete with H plus. Actually it is H plus, I am writing it as water. Chloride ion has to compete with water. We here, because this is at cathode, this is at anode. Because cathode, Na plus or H plus will compete. H H+ will be present in the form of water only. Chloride ion and water will compete. Water will be in the form of OH- only. Now, our knowledge comes here. OH- chloride ion. Who will have a better discharge potential, lower discharge potential? Chloride ion. So, what is the ion which will undergo oxidation at anode? Chloride ion. Sodium ion, H+ ion. As I told you, you have to worry about the cationic reaction at cathode only when there are four ions are there. These four, our Na+ is not under that four. So almost whenever there is an aqueous solution, other than the cupric ion, mercuric ion, auric ion, or a silver ion, whatever it is, happily which will have a lower discharge potential? Water. So water or H+ ion undergoes reduction at cathode. Cl- undergoes oxidation at cathode, at anode, sorry. Sodium water undergoes reduction at cathode, chloride ion undergoes oxidation at anode. So how to represent it? Already how to write reaction of water at cathode, I told you. Cathode, 2H2O plus 2 electrons gives H2 plus 2OH-. Is that okay for you? Anode. 2Cl- give Cl2 plus 2 electrons. Cl2 plus 2 electrons. How many electrons here? 2. Now, what? What is the story of electrolysis of aqueous NaCl story? Aqueous NaCl is also called brine solution. I am subjecting it to electrolysis using inert electrodes. What is the gas liberated at cathode? Hydrogen gas. What is the gas liberated at anode? Chlorine gas. Quantitative. How many Faradays of electrons are passing? 2 Faradays of electricity. For 2 Faradays of electricity, how many moles of hydrogen gas is liberated at cathode? 1 mole. How many moles of chlorine gas is liberated at anode? 1 mole. This is quantitative part. So thus, not only did you say what are the products obtained at cathode and anode, but also said how to actually, what is the quantity of this particular products obtained also. Then you may ask me, so much of information is there, sir, in the objective orientation. Can you actually give me an idea? Yes, I'm keeping the same thing like this only. Aqueous NaCl, I'm showing you how to proceed. Technique, this is a beautiful technique that you can have. Aqueous NaCl has Na+ and Cl-. I'm not using water now. What is competing with Na+? H+. What is competing with Cl-? OH-. What is the ion that is getting discharged at cathode? H+ as what? H2. What is the ion that got discharged at anode? Cl- as a Cl2. What are the gases liberated at respective electrodes? H2 at cathode, Cl2 at anode. What is left over in the solution? Na+ and OH-. Thus, you are now in a position to tell not only the products obtained at cathode and anode, but you are also in a position to tell what will be the nature of the solution as the electrolysis progresses. If you see, you started with aqueous NaCl. You started with what? Aqueous NaCl. Is NaCl a salt of strong acid and strong base or not? Yes. Whose pH is equal to 7. During electrolysis, due to the liberation of hydrogen and chlorine, the leftover solution is becoming richer and richer in NaOH. Richer and richer in NaOH. The solution now becomes more and more alkaline. The pH, which was equal to 7, now slowly increases from 7 to nearly 13. Thus, what is the product, what is the leftover solution during electrolysis of aqueous NaCl, NaOH, what happens to the pH? pH progressively increases. I am actually finding out that only 2 to 3 minutes are there. Therefore, I may repeat this once again in the next class, but I am taking one more example to understand. Now, I am not going into more details. Technicality, technical, in the same way, how to proceed. Aqueous copper sulfate I am taking using platinum electrodes. I am giving you a technique, simple hint. Aqueous copper sulfate using platinum electrodes. Cupric ion competes with H plus cathode. Sulfate ion competes with OH minus anode. Tell me, is the cupric one, is the cupric ion and H plus ion, which has lower discharge potential? Don't forget, cupric is one among the four. Cupric ion. So, I'll write the equations later. Copper is deposited at cathode. Sulfate ion. Sulfate ion is competing with what? OH minus ion. As I told you, OH minus always has a lower discharge potential compared to any anion except chloride bromide. Therefore, sulfate OH minus, who will be the winner? OH minus. So, what is liberated? O2. Thus, products obtained at cathode and anode when aqueous copper sulfate is subjected to electrolysis. A technique, aqueous copper sulfate subjected to electrolysis using platinum electrodes. Copper deposits at cathode. Oxygen gets liberated. Leftover, you see, leftover, very easy. H plus sulfate, H2SO4. Is it not a beautiful technique to remember that? On the electrolysis of aqueous copper sulfate, as the electrolysis proceeds, the leftover solution becomes richer, richer and richer in sulfuric acid. One point, acidic strength increases. You start with a copper sulfate, which is a salt of strong acid weak base, whose pH is less than 7. But as it becomes richer and richer in sulfuric acid, pH progressively decreases. One point. Second thing, what is the color of copper sulfate? Blue in color. That blue color slowly starts disappearing. At a particular stage, it becomes colorless. Why does it become colorless? No more copper sulfate. Slowly it is converted to sulfuric acid. Did you understand? I have many such techniques in the electrolysis, but I can go into the details in the next class. Thank you very much.